Hello, my name is Bhaskar. I'm from Wizako. This 12 to 15 minute video is an executive summary slash overview about the GMAT examination. Before you start your GMAT prep, you need to have a good understanding about what the test is all about. What are the different sections in the test? How is it scored? What is a good score? And what is the window of preparation that you're looking at? That's what this video covers. We'll be looking at four aspects of it. We'll start with the different sections of the GMAT. We'll get an overview about what is exactly tested in each of these sections. What is the competitive score for each section and how long would you have to prepare to reach that number? Third, let's look at how is each of these sections scored? What is the number that you get for each of these sections? And what is the overall score in the GMAT? And lastly, we'll also look at the order in which you'll be able to take these different sections. Let's start with the different sections of the GMAT. The GMAT examination comprises four sections, not necessarily appearing in the order in which I'm stating it. We'll look at the first one, which is analytical writing assessment, in short, AWA. The task at hand is to write an essay, which is called analysis of an argument. The duration is 30 minutes. The next section is integrated reasoning or the IR section. The duration of this section is also 30 minutes. What you'll have to do is answer 12 multiple choice questions. The next section is the quantitative reasoning section. The duration is 1 hour and 2 minutes, 62 minutes. You'll have to answer 31 multiple choice questions in this section. And lastly, it's a verbal section. Duration is 65 minutes, 1 hour and 5 minutes. You'll be answering 36 multiple choice questions from the verbal section. In total, not counting the optional breaks that you'll be allowed, the duration of all of these four sections is 3 hours and 7 minutes. So it's a little over 3 hours. That's what is the total duration of this test. Let's delve into each of these sections, understand what is actually tested, what is the task at hand. Let's start with AWA. What is actually tested? What is the task at hand? You'll have to write an essay that critiques an argument. What you'll be presented with is an argument which runs to about 45 to 60 words in length. You'll have to find out what is the fallacy in the reasoning of the argument and write an essay critiquing it. How are you evaluated? On two aspects. One, are you able to identify the fallacy in the argument, which means you need to know the structure of a good argument. And second, you're also evaluated on whether you're able to write effectively, whether you have been able to communicate what is required to critique the argument in an language which adheres to the standard rules of written English. How are you scored? This section is scored on a scale of 0 to 6. Scoring moves in increments of 0.5. So your score could be a 5, score could be a 5.5, 6, 4.5, and so on. What is a competitive score? Any score that's 5 or more is a competitive score. Have this perspective. 5 or 6 will not make any difference to your final admit. 5 right now in 2018 corresponds to 53 percentile in the GMAT, which is roughly half of the GMAT test takers have a score which is a 5 or a 5.5 or a 6. So getting a 5 is not very difficult. But keep this perspective in mind. If you do not get a 5, if you get a 4 or less could actually harm your possibility of getting an admit. What is a 4 in the percentile system right now? 4 translates to 17 percentile. Essentially means that you are in the bottom 20 percentile of the people in terms of your ability to critique an argument and present it in a structured written form. So don't fall into this category. 5 or more is good. How long do you need to prepare to get this? Roughly about 12 to 15 hours of preparation should see you there. Right? This is a perspective about the first section. Let's move to the second one, integrated reasoning. 12 multiple choice questions, the duration is 30 minutes. Questions are presented to you in four formats or four different types of questions are available. The first one is graphic interpretation. You are given a pictorial representation of data and a question that follows it. Second one is table analysis, tabular representation of data and a question that follows it. Third one is two-part analysis. A question will have a stem and you'll have to answer two parts based on the stem. More often than not, these two parts are linked to each other. The answer to these two parts are linked to each other and they are tied through an umbilical cord to this data presented. You need to get both parts right in order to earn credit. If you get one of these parts right and the other one incorrect, you don't get credit for that question. And lastly, the fourth type is multi-source reasoning. You have more than one source of data and you need to answer questions that follow that. What is the section scored on? How is it scored? Scored on the scale of 1 to 8. And it moves in increments of 1. What's a competitive score? 6 to 8 is a competitive score. 6 in 2018 translates to 70th percentile. So 6, 7, 8 all are competitive scores. How long do you have to prepare to get that? Roughly about 25 to 30 hours of preparation will see you there. What else is there? If you score anything from 6 to 8, I said it's not going to make a difference to your final admit. But a 3 on 8 could actually get into the way of you getting an admit. A 3 right now in 2018 corresponds to 24th percentile. Essentially means that you're in the bottom quartile of the people who appeared for the GMAT. So don't get into this level. 6, 7, 8, all are good. 8 on 8 is not going to translate into an admit, but 3 on 8 could take an admit away from you. What else? This section has an on-screen calculator. It's available only for this section. So if you have to do any calculation, you can use this calculator to get to the answer. But the truth be told, more often than not, you will not have a need to do this. You'll be able to do most of these calculations mentally and do it that way because the next section, quant section, you will not have access to this calculator. So move on to the third section, which is a quantitative reasoning. 31 questions, 62 minutes. We have seen that questions are presented to you in two variants. The first is problem solving. 55 to 60% of the questions are of this kind. They are multiple choice questions. What are these? Plain vanilla questions. You have a question, a quantitative reasoning question, followed by five answer choices. Only one of these answer choices is right. You solve the question, mark the answer, and move on. The second variant is called data sufficiency. About 40 to 45% of the questions of these 31 questions are of the DS variety. These are trickier than the problem solving. Concept tested is the same, but what is actually tested is you need to pick from the two statements given there whether the data presented in those two statements is sufficient, is enough to answer a question that is asked. Let's move on to look at what is actually tested. What is tested is arithmetic, algebra, and geometry. And these are the rough splits. 40% of the questions will be from arithmetic, 40% from algebra, and 20% from geometry. You also have word problems that come from arithmetic and algebra. Perspectives about this section, how is it scored? And an extra feature called the computer adaptiveness. This section is a computer adaptive section. What does it mean? The difficulty of the next question that's shown to you is determined by the correctness of the answer that you're given for this question. Let's say you're answering question number one. If question number one is correct, the level of difficulty of question two is likely to go up. If you answered question one incorrect, the level of difficulty of question two is likely to go down. So what they're essentially saying is the difficulty level of a particular question is determined by the answer that you gave to the previous one. How's this section scored? Scored on a scale of 0 to 60, it moves in increments of 1. Though the scaling is 0 to 60, the highest possible is 51. A comparative score is anything from 49 to 51. In 2018, perspectives about percentile, 51 corresponds to 96 percentile. So 4% of the GMAT test takers manage the score. A 49 corresponds to 74th percentile. So you're still in the top quartile, approximately the top 25 percentile. So 49 to 51 is a comparative score. How do you prepare for it? Wizako's online course at gmat.wizako.com is a very comprehensive and one of the most affordable programs for this particular section. A couple of topics are available as free. Try them before you sign up for the course. How long would you have to spend to get to the score of 49 to 51? An investment of 125 to 150 hours would be required. So we looked at the third section, quantitative reasoning. Let's move on to the last one, which is verbal reasoning. 36 multiple choice questions to be answered in 65 minutes. Three variants of questions appear. Sentence correction. What is actually tested is grammar and communication. About 13 to 14 out of these 36 questions are from sentence correction. The easier one in terms of preparation, very highly correlated to the number of questions you solve during the preparation phase. You do justice to it, should get most of it right. The second section is the reading comprehension. Reading comprehension, around 4 to 5 passages appear, each of length not exceeding 350 words, less than 350 words. 2 to 4 questions per passage and another 13 to 14 questions in total. This is one section where the extent of preparation and the scores are not necessarily correlated. Some of us are better read than the others. Those who have a better reading habit will score here without much effort. Others need to put in a lot of effort. The third variant is critical reasoning. About 9 to 10 questions appear from this. These are based on logical arguments. What kind of questions do you get? Get questions that will ask you to strengthen an argument, weaken an argument, infer and conclude an argument, evaluate an argument, and such stuff. Perspectives about this section. This section is also a computer adaptive section. What we mentioned in quant holds good here too. How is this section scored? Scored again on a scale of 0 to 60, moves in increments of 1 points. Though the scaling is from 0 to 60, the maximum possible is only 51 points. 51 in verbal corresponds to 99th percentile. What's a competitive score? 38 or more is a competitive score. 38 in 2018, 38 corresponds to 85th percentile. A 40 would correspond to 90th percentile. A 44 is 98th percentile. 45 to 51, all of these are 99th percentile. So it gives you a perspective of what is a competitive score. Anything over 85th percentile is a competitive score. Keep this also in mind. What's the effort required? 150 hours. It's tougher to score in the verbal section than in the quant section, as is evident from this percentile itself. But also keep this in mind, a lower point could give you a higher percentile. A 49 in quant, if you recall, translated to a 74th percentile. A 49 in verbal is a 99th percentile. Something as low as 38 is an 85th percentile, much higher than what it is for quant. So the flip side of being a tougher section, being a section where it is tougher to score, is that lower points fetch you higher percentile. Let's look at one other thing, which is the overall score that all of us talk about. What does the overall score comprise? It comprises only two sections, the quant section score and the verbal section score. What you scored on 0 to 60 in these two is put together into one composite number whose range is from 200 to 800 and it moves in increments of 10. So your score could be a 700, 710, 720, so on and so forth. What's a good score, competitive score for Indian test takers? 700 plus is a competitive score. 700 plus in 2018 translates to 88th percentile in the GMAT. Is there something known as a great score? Certainly yes. 740 plus is a great score, will get you scholarships. 740 plus right now translates to 97th percentile. 750 is the 98th percentile. 760 and above, all of those are 99th percentile. So 740 and above are all great scores. What should you keep in mind? AWA and IR are not a part of this 700 or 800, 200 to 800 score. These are standalone points which are given to you, but are also taken into consideration when schools look at a student's GMAT score. You cannot wish this away. If let's say you have a 4 in this and 3 in this and you have a 750, probably these two are going to come in the way of your admit despite having a 750. So do not ignore these two sections. Lastly, let's look at the fourth aspect. In what order will you be able to take this section? That's called the select section order. There are three options available to you. These have been made available from July 2017. Prior to that, the only option that was available was the default one. The default one is you started with the AWA and IR, each of 30 minute duration. You could break for 8 minutes, an optional break, and then you have to take the quantitative reason section for a duration of 62 minutes. Take a break of 8 minutes and then wrap it up with 65 minutes of verbal reasoning. This is the default one. They provided you with two more options since July 2017. The second one is you start with the verbal reasoning section, answer it for 65 minutes, take an 8 minute break, then move to the quant section, do it for 62 minutes, take an 8 minute break and wrap it with IR and AWA in this order for the next 60 minutes. The third option, you start with the quant section, spend 62 minutes on it, take an optional 8 minute break, move to the verbal section, spend 65 minutes on it, take an optional 8 minute break and wrap it with IR and AWA in this order. What is a good option? And I think I've got a separate video which addresses that aspect. Most important thing is, when do you have to make this choice? You make this choice at the test center on the day of the test. And you'll be provided 2 minutes to make this choice. You'll be doing it on the computer in which you'll be taking the test. What if you did not do anything? The default option is the one that is checked and the test will appear in this order for you. Let's quickly summarize whatever we have discussed. The four sections in the GMAT, AWA, IR, each of duration 30 minutes. Quant section, 31 questions, 62 minutes. Verbal section, 36 questions and 65 minutes. A total of 3 hours and 7 minutes is what the test lasts, excluding the two optional breaks. Couple of other aspects to keep in mind. It's an expensive examination. How much does it cost? It costs US$250 to take the test once. Can you retake the test? Yes, you can retake the test. The duration between two attempts has to be a minimum of 16 calendar days. How many times can you take the test? You're allowed to take the test 5 times in a revolving 12-month window. What does it actually mean? If let's say you took the test on the 1st of August 2018, then from 1st of August 2018 to 31st July 2019, you'll be allowed to take the test 5 times. Is there a cap on the number of times you can take in a lifetime? Yes. A student can take the test only 8 times in a lifetime. If he or she is interested in taking more than 8 times, has to take a special permission from GMAT to get this done. One last aspect for Indian test takers, the only proof of identity that's available to you to present on the day of the test is the Indian passport, a valid Indian passport. In summary, the most important thing that matters to you as you're starting the preparation is basically this. What is the total prep time we are looking at? 300 to 320 hours for all four sections, not counting the time that you need to invest in mock tests. Roughly about 6 to 10 mock tests is what each student will take. Each test is of duration 3 plus hours, and it'll take you about 3 hours to analyze it. So you're talking about another 60 hours of testing plus analysis time. So budget for a 350 to 400 hour investment if you are very sure, if you want to score a 700 plus in the GMAT. How does Wizako help you? When you're starting your preparation, if you're good at verbal, back the verbal and keep it. Spend some time, spend some 100 hours. Put something like the way you put money in Provident Fund. Grab the verbal section. Ensure that you'll be scoring 40 plus in the verbal if you're good in verbal, and then move on to quant. Conversely, for most Indian test takers, this is what is going to hold good. They're reasonably good in the quant section. So back the quant. Spend 125 to 150 hours working on the quant section initially. Back that Q51. Ensure that any day you take the test, you can get a Q51 or a Q50, and then start working on your verbal. If this is the approach you're planning to take, look at GMAT's Wizako's online GMAT quant course. It's available at https://gmat.wizako.com. It's the most comprehensive and affordable program that you can get started with. If you're looking for a classroom program, we run classes for GMAT at Chennai, both for quant and the verbal. Call us on this number. We covered quite a bit in this video. It's a lot of concepts to cover in one single video. Time you took a break. Use the break for two things. One, subscribe to this channel. And two, sign up for the most comprehensive and affordable GMAT quant course that's available online at gmat.wizako.com.